Good morning students, I welcome you all 10th standard students. I have already explained about structural organization of animals in the last video. You have learned how the animal kingdom classified and how they differ in their structural organization. In this chapter we are going to see about leech. The Indian common leech, Hirudinaria granulosa. Already you have seen the taxonomic position of the leech. It includes the phylum Annelida, class Hirudinia. Then habit and habitat also we have already seen. Now external morphology of leech. In this external morphology of leech, we are going to see the shape and size of the leech. The body of leech is soft. It is vermiform. Vermiform means it's like a worms. The another example vermiform of annelids is earthworm. It has elongated and segmented body. It becomes ribbon shaped when extended and almost cylindrical when contracted. Leeches may grow to a length of 35 cm. The next one, coloration. Dorsal surface of the leech is olive green in color and the ventral surface is orange yellow or orange red in color. Next, segmentation. Metamerism is the segmentation of the body. The body of leech is metamerically divided into 33 segments. The segments are arranged one behind the other. Each segment is further superficially subdivided into rings or annuli. A temporary clitellum is formed on segments 9 to 11, which is meant to produce a cocoon during the breeding season. During the breeding season, the clitellum is act as a reproductive organ. The next one is receptors. On the dorsal side, there are 5 pairs of eyes on the first 5 segments. Each segment bears a number of sensory projections called receptors. Annular receptors are located in each annulus and the segmental receptors are located on the first annulus of each segment. So segmental receptors are located in the segments of the body. Annular receptors are located in each annulus. Suckers. Leech has 2 suckers. The sucker located at the anterior end is called anterior sucker or oral sucker, which is ventral in position, occupying the first 5 segments. Next, the posterior sucker is formed by the fusion of the last 7 segments. The anterior sucker helps in feeding, while both the sucker help in attachment and locomotion. Next, external apertures. Apertures means openings. The body has 5 openings. They are mouth, anus, nephridiophores, male genital pore and female genital pore. First one is mouth. It is located in the middle of anterior sucker. Then anus. Anus is small aperture that opens on the mid dorsal side of 26th segment. In leech, 17 pairs of nephriopores are present on the ventral side from 6th to 22nd segments. One pair in the last annulus of each segment, apical lobe. The posterior limb of main lobe will form an apical lobe. Its anterior end is smaller. Then inner lobe is, it is very thin. So nephridio open to the exterior by 17 pairs of nephridiopores. They lie ventrally on the last annulus of each segment from 6th to 22. Nephridiopores are nothing but excretory organs. Next, male genital pore and female genital pore. Male genital pore. It is a mid-ventral opening situated between 2nd and 3rd annuli of 10th segments. It is situated between the 2nd and 3rd annuli of 10th segment, male genital pore. Then female genital pore, it lies mid-ventrally between 2nd and 3rd annuli of 11th segment. Female genital pore situated in the 11th segment. Then divisions of the body. The body of leech is divided into 6 regions. Cephalic region, head. It includes first 5 segments, 1 to 5 segments. Second region is preclitellar region, 6th, 7th and 8th regions. Then third one is clitellar region, 9th, 10th and 11th region. Middle region, 12th to 22nd segments. Caudal region means tail region, 23rd to 26th segments. Then posterior sucker, 27th to 33 segments. So totally the body is divided into 6 regions with 33 segments. So dear children, I will explain remaining things in the next video. Thank you, children.